short to understand, don't talk about courses or when there's nobody there, why do you want to learn?
Yeah.
Let's say that.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Welcome to the live session at Panjara Academy. Hope you all saw the video which we had posted. Today's topic is impact of lockdown on children. And we are going to discuss on what impacts are happening on children and how are we going to deal with it. Good morning, Sanuj. Good morning, Sanjay. Let's do a brainstorming on the topic, impact of lockdown on children. Can you even imagine what might be going on in children's mind when so much of uncertainty is around in the air? You can type your thoughts on the chat box. Good morning, Uma. Yeah, I'll call Ali here so you can, you know, chat with him.
I gave you a sort of overview on the normal general issues which we have been observing for the last 1 year or so, right from March of last year. Things started improving a little bit, children started, you know, at least stepping out in buildings. People said that we now see children coming out and playing and things of that sort. Suddenly now even that has disappeared. Forget about going out. Where's the chat box? Yeah, okay. So what I am concerned about is schools are definitely now out. Let us not even think of any possibility of children going to school anywhere in the near future. We have to live with that. But as I've been talking to you, what about the development, learning and growth of children? My concern is of that. So based on whatever I have told you, firstly, I would like to hear from you. What are your comments or doubts or whatever is there in your mind? Because as you know, everything goes by what is my takeaway, what is of concern to me and things of that sort. So while we have a lot of good mornings and things of that sort, I want to hear from you. For example, Sunot says that they feel choked. Yes, absolutely. Now that we identify these things, like yes, they feel choked, what do we do about it? What are each one of us doing about it? And what is it that we can do further to enhance whatever? So we are trying to put all our heads together, do some brainstorming and try to think, you know, which are the ways and means by which we can, you know, respond to the needs of the children. Now, as you know, last year, March, April, when the first lockdown came, we were talking more or less about, you know, it was like a vacation. And even parents thought of it more like a summer vacation, which was anyway due. Only difference being that you can't out, you can't go to your holiday resorts and things of that sort. But finally, when June, July, August came in, and when schools did not open, and when online classes started, a lot of doubts and questions have come in. Nikita said a very, very meaningful thing, feeling a sense of loss of purpose. I'm glad you identified that, Nikhat, because very few people are even thinking of that. We are trying to brush it under the carpet. We are just presuming, we are looking at, if you look at the media, social media, we are only talking about number of people who got COVID, number of people who died of COVID, number of people who could not get vaccination done, number of people who are whatever, you know, only those things are coming up all over the place. Is life coming to an end? Let me tell you, as a person who has lived for donkey's years in this world, I have seen the worst of situations, but human beings have always bounced back, be it riots and shutting down of cities, be it tsunamis, be it wars, be it whatever it is, we have bounced back. As Purnima has written, lack of social interaction and outdoor play time, that is one of the areas which we are not doing anything. As I said, I know of so many people who are not even willing to allow their child to go down within the enclosure of their own building and play with other friends. Anjana says they miss their friendly tricks in school. Online education is not working much. Goal setting is not taking place. Yes, at least those of us who are willing to introspect, who are willing to be truthful to our own selves, we do understand that things have not been right and things are not going right. We need to do something about it. We can sit and talk about, you know, how much vaccination should be given and what government should do and whether there should be more lockdowns or not. We can't influence. There are authorities, there are people who are doing whatever has to be done. Let them, you know, take care of that. Like Sunot says, locked up within four walls, we are starting to mirror each other's emotions. And children are picking up on parent anxiety, work stress, erratic sleep habits, binge watching of TV. Vinita says, I feel children are very disturbed and frustrated. As a result, they have lost all the enthusiasm and happiness and getting lonely, and some of them look sad most of the time. And are we going to just sit idly and watch this thing, you know, going on? That is right. Now I want, you know, to move into the realm of practical things. I have been constantly making lists of activities which are off screen, nothing to do with laptops and mobile phones, which the children can indulge in. Some of them they can do you know, alone. Some of them they can do with one or two, some sibling, cousin, neighbor, or whoever it is. Some can be done in a little bigger group by forming a group where, of course, the interaction has to be through screen, but activity should be off screen. Those are only representative what I am taking. Anjana says, I feel talking with the children and opening the reality of what is happening is important. I will just change that word, I feel like talking with the children, to say I feel like listening to the children. Please make them talk. This is something which has been always there much before this pandemic. Children want to be heard. Children want adults who are not going to pass judgment, not going to interrupt them, and not going to, you know, put them down when they say something, and just listen to what I have to say, what is going on in my mind. Then we'll see whether there's a solution for it or not. A discussion is very, very important, and the discussion should be 90% child talking, 10% adult talking. Then only I feel that it becomes a discussion. If a child is not talking, let's also take that. There are parents who've been telling me, my child doesn't open out and talk. My child is only stuck to the mobile. My child doesn't have anything to say. We have to create that platform. We have to stimulate their minds. We have to slowly nudge them and make them, you know, think or talk about certain things. It will start with a one-word answers or one-liner answers. But that is how you have to make a beginning. And I am talking about long term. Please remember, just keep it in mind that whatever we have lost in the last, let's say, 15 months or so, I don't know what is going to happen in the next 15 months or even more. So let us start this, looking at it from a long-term perspective. Some people are doing good work, I know. They are trying to involve children in something, but they are looking at it almost as short term. You know how we used to do when summer vacation comes and children say that I'm getting bored and all that. They would get some activity or something and say, okay, you know, 1 month instead of the child sitting at home getting bored, I'll put him in the swimming classes or I'll teach him some music or something. By the time the school will reopen then. Here we are not talking about that. Here we are talking about the long-term continued development of the children. And children learn a lot from each other. That's the point that we have been raising all the time, that children should be given an opportunity. As I mentioned sometime back, even sitting in the school in the break and gossiping about their mothers. My mother is the worst mother in the whole world. What, man, what you are talking about? You come and see my mom, what sort of a monster she is. That used to give some reassurance to the child that the world is not such a bad place. My mother is not my enemy. I can make do with certain things. All this is what they are losing out on. In fact, even a simple thing like giving them privacy. We've spoke about talking to the children, listening to them and things like that. What about giving children, please check whether the child is being given the privacy to laugh, joke, gossip with his or her friends without any adult overhearing what is going on. I'm sure there are ways and means that we can do it. Specify some time and say, during this time, you are on your own with your friends. I give you all the freedom. Nobody will eavesdrop on you. Nobody will overhear or something of that sort. You can go to such and such place where you have all the privacy and talk to whoever you want to. That is one. The second thing is connecting children to neutral elders. Identify at least 1, 2, 3 elders whom the child connects to. I'm sure if you think, you will be able to come across such people. You may have a sister, a cousin, a neighbor, a colleague in office, or somebody whom the child is fond of. Every child is fond of some elder or the other because they somehow come and connect with them. I have a kid in the neighborhood who walks in. And whenever she comes and, you know, sits down, she tells me, Uncle, can I sit next to you? And she comes and occupies the chair next to me. And while talking, she slowly starts leaning on me. I came to know that her father is no more. And I realized how much she is missing that fatherly touch and that fatherly affection and things of that sort. It's not at all difficult. And this is not even my child, this is a neighbor's child who just, you know, hangs around in the locality. She just plays around and she happened to be walking in and, you know, she got connected to my family and things of that sort. That's how she started coming in. But we have to make those efforts to reach out to these children. We have our own issues, I agree. Many of us as adults are ourselves facing a lot of issues. Some of us have had the tragedy of losing somebody, you know, to death. I'm not saying it is a COVID death because I'm still questioning myself how many people are dying of COVID and how many people are dying of, you know, negligence and wrong treatment and anxieties and panic and this and that. That's a topic by itself. Maybe some other time we'll discuss that. But right now my concern is, even if you had bereavement, even if your job has been threatened or your income has come down, even if you have your frustrations of being locked in and not able to go out and go to your club or meet friends or whatever it is, that is something you have to deal with at an adult level. Remember, you at least have choices. When there is no physical lockdown, you can go to a friend who is pretty far away, go and spend time with your friend and entertain yourself. You can take up so many such activities, you can do so many things. Children do not have that independence to do it. Children don't even have the knowledge to do it. I told you that this neighbor, I really thank the mother that she allows this kid to roam around within that area. So she has pointed out and said, don't go beyond this limit, but you can roam around here. And this child has found her own friends. I told you, she just happened to be, you know, one day talking to my daughter, and then she got friendly, and that's how she came in. And those are the type of things that happen. But are we at least doing that part of the thing, encouraging, allowing, you know, children to find their own ways and means? And along with that, if we can be that, you know, encouraging thing, so the child goes out, you know, into the compound or wherever it is, plays for some time and come back. Can we encourage the child by asking, did you meet somebody who is interesting? Did you like anybody? You don't have to restrict yourself to your friends. You can talk to certain elders also. I remember, you know, long back when such and such aunt had come, you were so thrilled when she was talking or discussing something, and she was telling about you and you, how she was telling about herself and how fascinated you got. Shall I put her on the phone to you? Can I request her when she's free to have a chat with you? Once she does that, don't enforce. Just ask casually, do you want, let me know when you want to talk to her again. That's it. Not even, did you like talking to her? Because the child feels compelled to say what is politically correct. So just a simple thing, like, let me know whenever you want to talk to her next. If somehow the child doesn't connect, the child will not ask you. Move on to something else. If the child does connect, she'll say, yes, I do want to talk to her. When can I talk? Okay, I'll check with her when she's free and things of that sort. We will get to talk to her and things of that sort. So these are very small, very simple ways. But what I am concerned about is that we have to have a vision. We have to look forward. The plan should be, according to me, at least a 3-year plan. Children are going to get affected. We are now sitting here and discussing on the 1st of May 2021. I would like you to make a 3-year plan ending on 1st of May 2024. What is it that I am going to do with the children with whom I am connected? And also, as I told you, with some children who are not directly my responsibility, but they are children, all said and done. So if I have a friend's child, if I have a neighbor's child, if I have a relative's child, I should not be so indifferent and say that let the parents take care of them. What have I got to do with it? For example, I know some very nice committed, you know, teachers who have been, you know, continuously interacting with their students on their own. In their free time, they have been making phone calls to their students, not to talk about studies and portions and tests, but just to inquire how you are. And those children feel so thrilled that such and such ma'am or such and such sir called me up, spoke to me. In today's world of social media and group activities and all that, everybody is available on groups. So somebody posts a message and there are 30 people or 300 people who read it, and then they forward it to somebody else, and this fine. That has got a lot of entertainment value, but entertainment does not mean emotional well-being. Entertainment is like getting drunk. When you get drunk, you forget all the problems of the world, right? But the intoxication comes down. Nasha utar jata hai. And then when you wake up, it is worse. You may have a hangover, you may have a headache, right? The same thing happens when you are trying to run away from reality through entertainment. If the entertainment is watching movies, watching videos, even, you know, sharing those videos, oh, these cute little puppies. Every second or third person I know is sharing videos of puppies, whether they are animal lovers or not. And the other person says, yeah, great, and they give that thumbs up sign, or they give this sign or something of that sort. That is not serving any purpose whatsoever. Please understand that. In fact, the more you are indulging in that, the more you are neglecting the real learning, which can be done through fun. That is the best part of it. Learning, when I am talking about social and emotional learning, what I told you in the first half of the program also, is not as boring or as monotonous as many other school subjects are. So you can take advantage of the fact now that these children are available to you. If you have the time or inclination, please remember that. And even if you are busy, let's say you are working parents, you have so many other responsibilities and all that, you can share, no? Every parent does not have to be, all the time behind his or her one or two children. You can find other parents. You can share the activities. So today I am very busy, I am talking, let the other person take care. We can pool in and do things. Kerali says, real appreciation for parents of children with special needs for their patience and innovative activities to keep their children happy and occupied. The teachers and therapists are trying their best to keep connected with parents and children. Yes, Kerali, I've been getting feedback, I've been talking to special educators like you, and hats off to all of you who are really reaching out to what we call as special children, or rather I would say children with special needs. These are children who are even more isolated. They have greater needs because they are not tech savvy. They can't do online classes and these and that. So they have much more limitations. They are also children who need our support. They are also children who we need to, reach out to. And that is what we need to do. In fact, extending from what Kerali said, I would say every child has special needs. In some form or the other, it is up to us to identify. We have to find out what are the special needs. Here is a child who seems to be feeling a little lonely. Here is a child whose self-esteem seems to be going down. Here is a child who seems to be feeling guilty about what he or she has done and feels that I am a bad person and I have done something sinful and something of that sort. There may be a child who is not being able to cope up with these online classes but doesn't want to admit. I've had so many children like that. Plain and simple, one question asked, how are you enjoying? Yes, it is very good. I like it. I am doing this. You spend another 15 minutes, make the child slowly open out, and then the child says, I'm fed up of this online classes. I don't think I am learning. I don't think anything good is happening. These are the things that we need to, work on at an individual level, also as groups. From our side, we are there, we are doing whatever best we can. In fact, the next CCAD program, the Child and Adolescent Development Program, which we are starting online 15th May, I'm going to try and focus as much as possible on practical tips on how to improve the lifestyle firstly and the social emotional learning of children. So I am continuously collating tips, techniques, methodologies. I would like you also, if you have something, please send it to us. Any activity that you have done with children which you felt has helped the child or is helping the child, please share with us. I think all of us can put our heads together and come out with ways and means. We can also share where things do not work also, so that everybody doesn't have to reinvent the wheel. So somebody can say that I tried this method but somehow this doesn't seem to be working, or in the worst case there seems to be a negative backlash of that thing, so it is better that we avoid these sort of things and we can move on to other alternatives and other means and things of that sort. Please put your heads together. I remember long back there was an anecdote or whatever you call it, saying that you know, which is the society or which is the country which has the best future. Somebody said oil, somebody said IT, somebody said something, but finally they said the society or the country which takes maximum care and gives maximum attention to the younger generation, they are the ones which, you know, have the best of future. Yes, Anjana, your children are putting on a daily mail with their friends. That's what I want you to. They are doing whatever little the children can do. It is up to us now to keep on encouraging them, giving them positive strokes, exploring with them, using their ingenuity, their creativity. Tell them, oh great, you have done it, let me also do it. Don't forget the bottom line, which I keep emphasizing on, that children are very poor at listening to their elders. They are very good at mimicking them. What you do has a great impact on children. Yes, Anjana says they discuss, write, interview people of different fields, cooking day, joke day, all this can be done. It is not rocket science. It doesn't require you to be a psychologist. It just requires you to be an adult who is genuinely and deeply concerned about the young generation. Be it your child, be it your student, be it your counselee, whatever it is. A child is a child, and the child is going to grow up so fast. Before you know it, the child would have flown out of the nest. And if we do a hodgepodge job, if we do not give the right upbringing, we are spoiling an adult. Don't forget the proverb which says, it is far easier to build strong children than it is to repair broken men. With that little message, I leave you on, and we shall meet next Saturday, when I am going to have a very nice and interesting discussion with you on kya karo ma hu na. Let's see what we can discuss. Thank you and bye bye.